Welcome to my channel MK Mediguide Lectures, learning with artworks like drawing and calligraphy. In this video, we will discuss about the sympathetic nervous system. Well, the sympathetic nervous system is a division of the autonomic nervous system along with the parasympathetic nervous system. The sympathetic division actually prepares the body for energy expending stressful or emergency situations, which include anger, fear or anxiety, as well as exercise, and that's why this division is known as the fight or flight response. And with this is the sympathetic neurons arise from the thoracic and lumbar regions of the spinal cord. So this division is also called the thoracolumbar division. By going into more detail on the anatomy and physiology of the sympathetic nervous system, here I'm drawing the brainstem and spinal cord. As I told earlier, that sympathetic neurons arise from thoracic and lumbar regions of the spinal cord. So here I'm dividing the spinal cord into cervical, thoracic, lumbar and sacral segments. So here in this diagram, the sympathetic neurons arise from 12 thoracic and first 2 lumbar segments of the spinal cord. Before going into the nerve pathways to each organ, let's talk about the sympathetic ganglia first. Well, ganglia are structures that are located outside the CNS and in which free ganglionic neurons synapse with postganglionic neurons. The important sympathetic ganglia in our body include the paravertebral or sympathetic chain ganglia, which are arranged in a longitudinally segmental manner on both sides of the vertebral column. And each ganglion is interconnected with each other by a nerve trunk. Both the chains extend from the skull to the coccyx. But here, I have drawn only the one side paravertebral ganglia, but just imagine that there are 2 paravertebral ganglia present on both sides of the spinal cord. Other ganglia of sympathetic division are the free vertebral or collateral ganglia, and these are located outside of the sympathetic chain ganglia, far away from the spinal cord as compared to the sympathetic chain ganglia. Free vertebral ganglia are situated in thorax, abdomen and pelvis and consist mainly of the celiac, superior mesenteric and inferior mesenteric ganglia. The free ganglionic neurons may synapse with postganglionic neurons in the sympathetic chain ganglia, while some of which travel off and down and make synapses with other neurons, and other neurons directly pass from here, for example, free ganglionic fibers from T5 to L2 segments and synapse with postganglionic neurons in the collateral ganglia, that is the celiac, superior mesenteric and inferior mesenteric ganglia, as I have drawn here. Now, let's just briefly overview some organs and tissues that are innervated by the sympathetic nervous system and how these organs respond to it. These organs in tissues include the eyes, the salivary glands, which secrete saliva to our oral cavity, After death, the lungs and related airways. Then we have the heart, which is the vital target organ. In other organs like stomach, liver, spleen, the large and small intestines, adrenal medulla, kidneys, urinary bladder, genital organs, and blood vessels. Now, discussing briefly that how these organs respond to when they get sympathetic impulses from the central nervous system. These effects include the dilation of the eye FIFO upon stimulation by the first ganglionic neurons coming from the sympathetic chain ganglia, and also the salivary glands in response to the innervation by the first ganglionic nerves from the sympathetic chain ganglia, result in inhibition of salivary secretion. The sympathetic first ganglionic nerves from the sympathetic chain ganglia targeting the lungs causes bronchodilation. The heart receiving sympathetic supply from different regions of the sympathetic chain ganglia in upon stimulation result in the increasing of the rate and force of contraction of the heart. The first ganglionic nerves from the celiac ganglion targeting the stomach leads to the contraction or closing of sphincters and decrease peristalsis. The liver, in response to the sympathetic impulses, increases the conversion of glycogen into glucose. Similarly, the spleen contracts in response to the impulses mainly from the celiac ganglion, resulting in discharge of stored RBCs into circulation. The large and small intestines are supplied with the nerves from the superior mesenteric ganglion and inferior mesenteric ganglion, and the overall effect is the inhibition of peristalsis, decreased tone, and contraction of sphincters. The sympathetic nerves innervating the kidneys arise from small ganglion, that is aortico-renal ganglion and renal ganglion, in response to the first ganglionic nerve stimulation, the secretion of renin occurs. Furthermore, nerve impulses from the inferior mesenteric ganglion innervate the urinary bladder, resulting in relaxation of detrusor muscles and contraction of trigonal and sphincter muscles. Other first ganglionic fibers arising from the inferior mesenteric ganglia innervate the genitalia and leads to orgasm. Besides, all the organs have two neurons between it and the central nervous system and sympathetic nervous system, except that of the neuron arising from lumbar region and without a synapse, innervate the adrenal gland and stimulate the release of adrenaline and noradrenaline into the blood. In addition to it, all the blood vessels do not respond the same to the sympathetic stimulation. That is, the blood vessels to the skeletal muscles, cardiac muscles, liver, and adipose tissues are dilated. In contrast, other vessels like that of supplying blood to GIT, kidney, and skin or constricted. Due to constriction of vessels to the kidneys and GIT, which decreases blood flow through these tissues, the result is a slowing of urine formation and digestive activities. At last, generally, the cell bodies of the free ganglionic neurons are found in the gray matter of spinal cord, and their axons leave the spinal cord through ventral root. Moreover, the axons of free ganglionic neurons are short and myelinated in comparison to the first ganglionic neurons, which are long and unmyelinated. The free ganglionic neurons mean the neurons that carry impulses from the CNS to the ganglia, while the first ganglionic neurons are the neuron fibers that carry impulses from the ganglia to the target organs. In addition, the free ganglionic neurons, including that of the adrenal gland, secrete acetylcholine while interacting with first ganglionic neurons. In almost all the first ganglionic neurons synapsing with effector organs, secrete norepinephrine as a neurotransmitter. In most of the cases, the free ganglionic nerve endings of the sympathetic nervous system are highly branched, permitting one free ganglionic neuron to interact with many first ganglionic neurons. And one fiber simulates about 20 of first ganglionic neurons. This arrangement allows this division to activate several effector organs at the same time. And with this, thanks for watching and support us by subscribing to our channel.